It seems doctors have been using it to engage with the public.
Okay, there's a Dr. Tristan Pei, whom I follow, not quite on TikTok, but on Instagram. He's cool. He's a dentist, and his page is fun. It's personal. He uploads educational videos like this one.
Are you feeling bad breath? This could be due to not cleaning your tongue well. You can use a tongue scraper to clean your tongue, or even a toothbrush. If not, you can always use a spoon.
Okay, so you follow him on Instagram, but you can find him on Facebook, you can find him on YouTube, and you can find him on TikTok.
Can you hear the kids in the background? This is so cool. He's got two girls. And he joins us now, Dr. Tristan Pei, who's a dentist at St. Andrew's Dental Surgeons. Dr. Pei, fascinating work. Congratulations on having more than 500,000 followers.
Hi, Anand, and hi, Yasmin.
Hey, nice Dr. Pei. Yeah, well, so tell us, how long have you been on social media to amass, you know, 500,000 on YouTube and TikTok is not a small feat.
Oh, thank you. I guess the growth is actually more starting last year during the pandemic when I have a little bit more time, and it all started from TikTok, I guess. Yeah. So what I did is that during pandemic, my daughters actually introduced me to TikTok, and basically they want me to play with it, and it was a way for me to bond with my two daughters. And I heard the music just now from the earlier video. Yeah, that's my daughter laughing at the background. now
so you're cool. Has it made you very cool as well? A cool dad?
I guess I would like to connect with them. Okay, and. They, all along when they are young, I wanted them to be a dentist, but, well, they told me that they want to be influencer.
Okay. I see. It's cooler to be
so I
vlogger.
I just pick up some
It's all is not lost yet. All is not lost because you've shown them that you can be a dentist and an influencer at the same time, right?
Yeah, a double whammy. Dr. Pei, who do you follow on TikTok? Who are your inspirational characters who do things terribly well?
Okay, there are many creators. Okay, on TikTok that has a fabulous content. But one of the top creators that I've been follow is Dental Digest. Okay, Anthony, which is a dental student in. Chicago University. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm his top fan.
And, so an apprentice is actually influencing the master because you're a full-fledged dentist. All right, what are the common questions that you got from, you know, your patients, your pool of patients, and just generally the public during the pandemic when we couldn't go just for regular maintenance during circuit breaker?
All right. One common question is surprisingly still about whiter teeth. Many people actually want whiter teeth, and they, most people want whiter teeth. So by brushing well, flossing well, it helps to remove all the surface stain. But we do have patients, we do have people from the social media that sharing with me, through interacting, we notice that a lot of people do sometimes brush a lot more harder. And by brushing harder, most people believe that will actually get the teeth cleaner, whiter, but it might turn out the other way when you use a hard brush. So always use a soft brush and gentle brushing. Otherwise, the enamel of the tooth can wear off, then the teeth get more yellow.
Okay, that's quite counterintuitive. But yeah, I've heard that piece of advice before as well. What else do they ask you?
The other thing is usually about bleeding gums also. Okay, and if the gums are bleeding, definitely a good idea to brush and floss better. Okay, brush two times a day, floss every night. And also a good idea to see your dentist every 6 months for a cleanup. Dental plaque over time will harden to form stones. So in a period of 6 months to a year, deposits still form, and when that form, our normal brushing and flossing doesn't get rid of the deposit.
Right.
So being a professional is still important, I guess.
Okay. Because you guys have the tools and the steady hands to break those stones down. Dr. Pei, more than 500,000 followers on TikTok. Has that translated to more people coming through the door at your dental practice?
We don't really go and get the numbers, but I do have patients coming in that they saw me on TikTok, and I also have existing patients who after wisdom tooth surgery, and they will have a phone on their hand, and they show me, is this you?
Oh, they want to take a picture with you, hopefully, and then post on their media.
And, Right. Yeah, very heartwarming.
Okay. So you're on so many, you know, social platforms. I mean, is there one that you prefer over the other? It seems like TikTok is the one that you actually, you know, I don't know, like more and spend a lot more time on.
All right, TikTok is the one that got everything started for me, and I guess that's where the affinity is, and that's where I get more of my contents from.
Okay.
And even on YouTube, I mean, the contents that I'm posting is more from the contents I created from TikTok that I loaded on YouTube.
Look, I think it's innovative. Your TikTok handle is Dr. Tristan Pei. And I just want to look at the time that you actually spent to produce this video. It's very interesting. I was looking at the CNA article about you. In the beginning, took half a day to shoot, edit, post. You've got it down to 2 hours, but you do this every day as part of your workflow. Interesting, right? You never thought in dental school this would be the case.
Never thought about it. Because we're all still learning, okay? And there is still plenty of things to learn, and this is something that I'm
in my heart, I'm still a student, so I'm looking at things to learn, and I won't be surprised if there's a TikTok social media module on dentistry courses soon in the near future. Dr. Pei, thank you very much for joining us on the show.
Thank
Dr. Tristan Pei is a dentist at the St. Andrews Dental Surgeons.